Hi everyone. I'm at the airport right now, and whenever I'm at an airport and I travel, I always get a little excited and I get nostalgic because it makes me think about reliability-centered maintenance. Because if you don't know, reliability-centered maintenance has its roots in the commercial airline industry. I'll tell you the story really quickly. So back in the mid-1950s, their philosophy and their belief was that equipment failure was more likely to occur as things got older. So time marched on, and they found themselves in the early 1960s with the emergence of newer aircraft with new systems like hydraulics, electronics, pneumatics, turboprop engines, and pressurized cabins. So much more complex equipment. So the crash rate started to increase, and it increased to a rate that was really very unacceptable to them. So based upon their belief at the time, they took their maintenance intervals and they shortened them. So they started doing maintenance more often. And what happened is actually three things happened. In very few cases, things stayed the same. In very few cases, things got better. But for the most part, things got worse. So that is what caused them to say, okay, we need a new way of doing business. Now, I don't have enough time to tell you all the details, but they're really quite fascinating. But the moral of the story is they identified that actually about 80% of failure modes when it comes to complex equipment fail randomly. And so they realized they needed a new way of doing business, and that's how reliability-centered maintenance principles were first born. So in 1968, within the commercial airline industry, they published MSG1, which stands for Maintenance Steering Group. And then in 1970, they had an update to MSG2. Well, around that time, the Department of Defense was really interested in how the commercial airline industry was making their maintenance plans. So they commissioned United Airlines to write a report. And that report was written by Stanley Nolan and Howard Heap, and they called their book Reliability-Centered Maintenance, and that was published on December 29th, 1978. So we are coming up on a 40-year anniversary for reliability-centered maintenance. This year will be 39, and then the following year we'll celebrate the 40 years. Anyway, that's how reliability-centered maintenance principles first emerged. It's a really exciting story. The details are really super exciting, and I'm just excited to share that with you today. Thank you for watching.